Since the Constitution is quiet on marriage, prominent traditional marriage defender Ryan Anderson wishes the Supreme Court would just toss the gay marriage controversy back to each state.
Where the Constitution is silent, the people in the states and our elected representatives should be making marriage policy.
Many court observers think since gay marriage is already legal in so many of the states, the justices might find it the simplest thing to go ahead and just say, let's make it the law of the land in all 50. But even a ruling as simple as that will have serious implications.
Anderson believes it'll set off a culture war as divisive as Roe v. Wade.
The same exact way. If they strike down these marriage laws, they got the Constitution wrong, they got marriage wrong. It's judicial activism.
And speak of activism, some states have already punished bakers, florists, and photographers who won't support gay marriage with their businesses. Now imagine if gay marriage is legalized nationwide. Franklin Graham recently wrote, quote, "There will be a storm of persecution against all people who follow God and his standards if this passes."
There seems to be a trajectory that things that are biblical are becoming less and less okay to say in the public sphere.
But that didn't stop Southern Baptist leaders this week declaring they won't accept or adhere to any legal redefinition of marriage issued by the Supreme Court or any other governmental body.
Several Christian leaders are calling for some form of civil disobedience.
Trammell says this is their stand.
Put in the position of choosing between obeying God and obeying government. We're going to obey God. And if there are legal implications because of that, that's something that we're willing to accept.
And they'll likely have to, as more people are branding backers of traditional marriage as no better than bigots or racists. As Republican presidential candidate Marco Rubio told CBN News' David Brody,
if you do not support same-sex marriage, you are labeled a homophobe and a hater.
They want to say that our beliefs about marriage are like the racist beliefs, and therefore, like the Bob Jones University case, we should lose our tax-exempt status.
Anderson is referring to a frightening exchange between Justice Samuel Alito and the government Solicitor General Donald Verrilli during the hearing on gay marriage. Alito asked, in the Bob Jones case, the court held that a college was not entitled to tax-exempt status if it opposed interracial marriage or interracial dating. So would the same apply to a university or a college if it opposed same-sex marriage? The Solicitor General replied, it's certainly going to be an issue. I don't deny that. I don't deny that, Justice Alito. It is. It is going to be an issue.
I was in the courtroom for oral arguments, and that those comments by the Solicitor General, that exchange about whether or not tax-exempt status for Orthodox, Jewish, Roman Catholic, Evangelical Christian, Latter-day Saint institutions, lots of religious believers who are at risk here, when he said it is going to be an issue, it was chilling.
Even without the court having made gay marriage the law of the land, Christians who take a biblical stand on gay marriage have found themselves challenged in the courts. So the implication is, any more legitimacy given to gay marriage means Christians batten down the hatches, rough days are ahead. Paul Strand, CBN News, the Supreme Court.